Hello students, we are now discussing about concept of uniform plane waves. First we'll see what is uniform plane wave. Next we'll see what is waves and types of EM waves. So here uniform plane wave, it is defined as the name itself, it is saying uniform and plane. The plane containing electric fields and magnetic fields, and the two fields are having same uniform magnitude, is nothing but uniform plane waves. And later I will explain you how it is plane wave, why we are calling it as a plane wave. Okay, so next, uniform plane wave, it is having both electric field and magnetic field, and the electric field is always along. We'll just assume the electric field is always along x direction and the magnetic field is along y direction. So E and H will occupy the plane of x and y, and the wave is always propagating along z direction, that is perpendicular to the plane containing electric field and the magnetic fields. So like this, electric field is along x direction and magnetic field, it is along y direction, but the wave is propagating along z direction. The wave is moving along z direction, but the electric field is varying along x direction, it is varying, magnetic field is varying along y direction, but the electromagnetic wave will move along z direction. The uniform plane wave is also called as plane wave, and it is also called as transverse electromagnetic wave. Why the name transverse? Transverse is nothing but perpendicular. Perpendicular to electromagnetic wave. So perpendicular to electromagnetic wave means electric field is along x direction, magnetic field is along y direction. So they are occupying xy plane. So transverse is nothing but the wave is propagating along z direction. So the direction of a wave is transverse to the plane containing x and y. Next, what is wave? Wave is nothing but the transportation, it is used for transportation of energy. Waves are transporting energy or information from one point to another point. Example, radio waves, TV signals, radio beams and light rays. And wave is a function of both time and space. As a space changes, space is nothing but coordinate system. Cartesian, cylindrical and spherical. X, Y, Z, rho, pi, Z, r, theta, pi. As the type of coordinate system changes, as the time changes, the wave characteristics will change. So wave is a function of both space and time. So next, we are having the classification of waves. Classification, there are two types of classifications based on their excitation, based on their oscillations and wave motion. First one is longitudinal wave and transverse wave. So longitudinal wave is nothing but the wave, it is a wave in which particles of a medium move in a direction parallel to the direction that the wave moves. Wave moves in, for example, z direction, then the particles of the medium will also move in the same direction. Transverse means there will be a perpendicular relation. The particles of the medium will move in direction perpendicular to the direction of wave moves. We'll discuss with one example. This is, consider a spring. Okay, this is a spring like this, and the two edges of the spring are holded with your hands. Either you can do compression or you just do the expansion. You just pull it one edge, when it is constant, hold it with your left hand. If the right hand, you can do the compression or you can do the expansion. If you do that like that, what will happen? The spring will either have a compression or it will be expanded. Okay, so how the oscillations will be there? Oscillations will be in this direction and the spring will also move in this direction. So the disturbance at one point will propagate throughout the medium. This is nothing but this is an example of longitudinal wave. That is oscillations. The particles of the medium, this is nothing but oscillations, and the spring, both are moving in same direction. Next, transverse wave. Example is drum. Consider a drum. If I do a sound with the stick, drumstick, then you can hear the sound. As the distance is going on increasing, the sound intensity will decrease. And the sound waves which are generating from the drum are like this. How the oscillations are there? In this direction. The wave, sound wave is also moving in this direction. So this is an example of longitudinal wave only. These two will come under longitudinal. Next, transverse. So this is nothing but, how can I explain? Here the oscillations in one direction, wave propagation will be in this direction. So your rope exercise. Generally we'll have a big size rope in the gym. So what we have to do in that gym with a rope means, always we'll do like this with two hands. Then what will happen? With two hands, if we are doing like this, the wave will do the oscillations up and down. So oscillations will be in up and down direction. But how the rope will move? The rope will move in another direction. So for the oscillations and the movement of rope are having 90 degrees with them. So this is come under transverse wave. Next, one more classification is there. Classification based on their ability to transmit the energy through the vacuum. Vacuum is nothing but empty space. So there are two types of waves, EM waves and mechanical waves. EM waves are produced by the vibration of charged particles. EM waves from sun travel to the earth through vacuum. If not, there could be no life on earth. So we can't say there is air in between or the path between the earth and the sun. So it could be a vacuum. So through the vacuum, EM waves are propagating. From the sunlight, we are getting EM waves. So all light waves are nothing but come under EM waves. So electromagnetic waves, we can conclude that electromagnetic waves can travel through vacuum. Next, another classification is mechanical waves. Mechanical waves means without medium, the mechanical waves cannot transmit from one point to another point. So these requires a medium in order to transport the energy from one location to another location. Example, sound waves. We can't hear the sound waves in vacuum. Next, we'll actually enter into the topic plane waves. Why the name plane? I can explain with the two examples. So if I consider a water source, consider a lake. Okay, here I am throwing a stone into the lake. Then we can observe the water waves are forming like a concentric circles. So if we observe, we can observe as the time is going on, we can observe more number of concentric circles, largest circles around this throne. So here, at the end of the lake, we can observe a straight line, not a concentric circle wave, because the radius is going on increasing and increasing, and the largest circle formed on the source can be viewed as a straight line, because we can't see whole circle, because at the end of the lake it is becoming a total, a big largest circle, and we can see some part of a circle, and that some part of a circle can be viewed as not exactly a circle, but may not be exactly a straight line, but it is looked like a straight line. Okay, in the same way, it is two dimensional. If I consider a point source transmitting the information, this is a point source, it is FM transmitter, for example. This is a transmitter, this is a radio section, FM radio section, and this is a radio, this is a transmitter. So this is a transmitting, we can hear in all four directions. Okay, so it is forming a sphere, three dimensional. So as the time is going on increasing, or continuously the transmitting the information, then continuously we can hear. As the distance is going on increasing, the radius of the sphere is also going on increasing. So finally, the largest sphere, we cannot see the largest sphere. If I consider a part of a sphere like this, as the distance is going on increasing, the sphere is becoming like this, and the sphere is becoming like this, and finally the largest sphere can be viewed as a plane. So that's why the name plane wave. So here, a sphere, spherical shape assumed at a larger distance, is called a plane wave. And what is uniform plane wave? Uniform means nothing but a wave whose value remains constant throughout a plane, which is transverse to the direction of propagation of wave. So it is transverse to the direction of propagation of wave means, if the wave is propagating along z direction, as already we discussed, the plane is nothing but xy plane. The wave is propagating along z direction. So electric field is along x direction, magnetic field is along y direction, but the wave will propagate along z direction. So generally, the waves are function of both the space and the time, we discussed already. But uniform plane wave is nothing but, uniform is nothing but constant. So electric field is constant along x direction, electric field is constant, magnetic field is constant along y direction. If they are constant, then they are not changing with respect to x and y. Then I can say that they are only function of z comma t. So here I can write the electric field is a function of z comma t, and the magnetic field is also a function of z comma t. So this is nothing but uniform plane waves. Thank you.